In 1920, King of Varanasi, a very big man, King of Varanasi, made a news all over the world. He was going to be operated without taking any anesthetic. It was a news all around. It never had been before in the history. No previous precedent. No pre-example. And not small operation. Operation of appendix. It's a very strange thing. You have to cut abdomen, you have to cut appendix, take it out, it might take long. 1 hour, 2 hours, and one never knows in which condition the appendix is. But the king of Varanasi told, you just do, don't worry, do the operation. I have taken a vow that I will not be unconscious under any drug. I will not take any drug and I don't want to be unconscious. I have taken this vow. So I will not go under chloroform. But I know myself. You can operate me without chloroform, without giving me any anesthetic. Doctors were worried. It's very painful. The operation is very painful, and a conscious person, he might not be able maybe to bear the pain and he might die. If it was just an ordinary man, they would have just forced to take the anesthetic, but he was the king of Varanasi. Not an ordinary man, a king of Varanasi. He told, don't worry, just do whatever you want to do. I will be not worried about my body or the pain. You just operate. The best team of Indian doctors, best team of the surgeons from India was there, and also one English, a doctor from England was there. He had the best team to operate upon. But no one was ready to operate without anesthetic. But that man, the king of Varanasi, did not agree, and he told, why you worry? Just operate. Just give me my spiritual book, Srimad Bhagwat Geeta. I will read some sentence of it. Just let me read 5 minutes. I will be lost in that, and then it's not the matter of pain. You can cut any part of my body. I will not realize. It had been the practice. I had been practicing it all my life. When I am in that, when I am in that spiritual condition, I am just there. I don't care about the body, so you just do whatever you like to do. I will be not caring. Why you worry? Just operate. But just give me the Srimad Bhagavad Gita, the spiritual book. Well, actually, doctors had no other option. Because if they don't operate, any time the appendix could burst and would have killed the man. If they operate without anesthetic, there was no pre-example like that. Also, that would be disaster. What to do? But if they don't operate, the man is going to die just in front of their eyes. At least take a chance. He was given his holy spiritual book, Srimad Bhagavad Gita. He read it for some minutes. The Bhagavad Gita dropped from his hand. The man was no more there. He knew Bhagavad Gita so very well. Even he did not need it, the book, he could just go on with his mind, with his memories, and could read whole the book. But just a start he took from Srimad Bhagavad Gita, and then he was just in. Doctors, they operated upon. It was a peak time. If they would have not operated, that man would have died. The appendix would have burst. It took 1.5 hours, and that man, not even an eye flicker moved. He just remained as he was. He was quite awake, but no matter whatever they are cutting, whatever they are doing, he was not caring. Just after the operation was done, the man was back in his normal senses, and it was made news all over the world. All the reporters, they publicized it. Even in India, that king of Varanasi is a man of great meditation. King of Varanasi also thought the same all his life, that he is a man of meditation. All the newspaper, everybody, all the people, they were just talking about the event, that thing, what happened, how the king of Varanasi went into the meditation and such operation could take place without any anesthetic. It made a great news, and people understood that he was a man of big meditation, of dhyana. But this is also concentration. It is not meditation, it is also concentration. That man was lost in Bhagavad Gita, so focused, so concentrated. Oblivious about all the other outer world. Not aware of any surrounding, just focusing his consciousness in certain direction, then that can be some particular subject, that can be some mantra, that could be some verses.